Made and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. I am so excited to be here this Sunday morning, and I welcome you to the new experience of new birth. Put your hands together wherever you are and give God the greatest praise that you can give him. We're here to convey the message that our God is a great God. Can you just type it on the screen? Just type great God. He is a great God, and we worship him in spirit and in truth. There is nobody like our God. How awesome he is. How magnificent he is. Go ahead and tag your friend and share this experience this morning with somebody, because somebody needs to know he's a great God. Hallelujah. We bless his name. Thank you, Lord. The choir's going to help you again this morning. Let's celebrate Jesus together. Come on. Señor, a great God. I said, Señor. We're talking about him this morning. He's a great God. So we love.
family today. We're lifting up the name of Jesus. And we're celebrating this month the birth of Jesus. We know he's a great God. We're just going to be talking about how good he is all day long. Y'all ready? Come on. Glory and honor. Say it.
Glory and honor. Dominion. Omnipotent, reigning with power forever.
Greater.
Greater than all you are, sovereign, sovereign.
Come on, let's get it in the house, hey.
God, great God.
Why don't you type that on the screen?
Worthy of honor and glory.
Put those hands up emojis on the screen. We're serving great God. We come to celebrate today.
Yeah.
an awesome God. There's nobody like our God. We worship him in spirit and in truth. We're so grateful that you're here worshiping our great God with us. If you haven't already said good morning to the Lord, this is a great time to say good morning, great God. Come on, type it in the chat. Good morning, great God. And if you haven't spoken to the people that are right there in the room with you, take a moment and say good morning to them as well. And maybe you're worshiping all by yourself. You can have somebody else be with you if you would share. Come on, tag. Start a worship party. Start it so that other people can experience what you're worshiping God with right now. The joy in your heart, they need to feel it as well. We're so glad that you are with us worshiping as one today. God is amazing, and there's nobody like him anywhere. Well, we want to share in this Christmas season. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. It's beginning to feel a lot like Jesus' birthday. And we're going to share with people who need to know about Jesus Christ. We're going to be sharing with children who need toys. And on this coming Saturday, December 19th, we're going to have Christmas City in Wakanda right here at New Birth. When we invite you, if you need toys for your children, to go ahead and sign up online. You can actually register ahead of time. We're going to have no walk-ups, no drive-ups. Although it is a drive-through experience, you must pre-register. You can find the information on the website. We don't want to just share with one another, but we want to share with everybody who's in need. We need more toys. So if you can get some toys to share with our children, we would be most grateful. You can drop them off here at the church during the week, or you can give online to Christmas City. While we're giving, while we're sharing, while we're celebrating Jesus' birth, we always want to make sure that we worship the Lord first and then those that are with us. So while you're making your list and checking it twice, make sure that you've got Jesus on there. We want to honor his birthday. Make sure you've got mama and them on your Christmas list. Don't leave them out. But I also want to encourage you today to include our senior pastor on your Christmas list. Let's give him gifts that he will enjoy. He's been serving, leading, teaching all year long through this pandemic, and we want to offer him a Christmas gift that he will like. And so you can do that by giving a Christmas love offering to Dr. Jamal Harrison Bryant. Join us as we celebrate the gift that God has given us here at New Birth. There is always so much going on here at New Birth. We don't want you to miss anything that's happening. So while you're sharing this experience with others, making sure that others are tagged in so they don't miss the word that's about to come, I want you to also not miss what's happening here at New Birth. Watch this.
For the visitors that don't know what's going on, let me just give you a news flash. We are New Birth. And this is how we roll.
It's been 2 years since Dr. Bryant delivered his first sermon here as our newly appointed pastor. Since then, he's galvanized our ministry.
Something good is getting ready to happen.
He has taken us to new levels, impacting lives spiritually and mentally. Even throughout the unprecedented health, social, and political changes of 2020, Dr. Bryant has been able to stand as a beacon of pastoral leadership. As New Birth opens its arms wide for those in need, we thank God for Dr. Bryant's vision, fortitude, and determination. Celebrating Dr. Jamal Harrison Bryant.
Hey, and it's Christmas time,
and we want to show our leader and shepherd, Pastor Bryant, our love and appreciation. Send your gifts and cards by Sunday, December 20th, and Merry Christmas from New Birth.
And because of the holidays, don't forget there's no group therapy for the remainder of the year. Spend time with your family and pray for our members who are experiencing illness and loss.
By the grace of God, each and every week, the King's Table continues to feed the community. And if you're in need, just pull up Saturday from 10 a.m. until 12 noon right here at New Birth. Just pop the trunk. We'll fill you up at the King's Table.
It's time for our annual Christmas City toy giveaway. New Birth, the need is great. We need your support. Please donate toys or contribute online through our website, PushPay or Givelify. Wake up and worship with us Christmas Day. We invite you to join us for a virtual worship Friday, December 25th, 9:30 a.m. Don't miss this powerful message as we celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And you don't want to miss our New Year's Eve celebration Thursday, December 31st, 12:30 p.m. and 10:30 p.m. Musical guest for 10:30 p.m. service, the uplifting and powerful vocalist, Kiara Shears. Tell your family, your friends, and your neighbors to tune in. And that's gonna do it for our video announcements.
In case you didn't know, we serve a great, big, wonderful God. Today we just want to worship our King. We want to worship our Savior, Jesus Christ, our Savior. Can you just begin to worship Jesus wherever you are? Come on, let's just begin to lift our worship. Let's lift our song. Let's lift our voices. Come on, somebody just begin to worship Jesus. Come on, wherever you are, just begin to worship Jesus. You are God, we worship you, Jesus. We give you glory this morning. It's absolutely nobody like you. Nobody like you, Jesus. That's it, wherever you are, type it on the screen. Just begin to type on the screen. Just begin to worship. Make your house your sanctuary. Come on, praise team. Right here, say, you are God. Come on.
Your name.
Somebody say that name in your house. Say it.
Jesus.
Declare his name today.
Jesus.
Alpha and Omega.
Jesus.
Jesus, we reverence.
Jesus.
Glory.
We reverence your
There is no question that we love God because we keep feeding his sheep. Every Saturday during this pandemic, we've been able to bless thousands who otherwise would have been inflicted by food insecurity. I'm grateful that we're able to represent God out loud, that there's been no Saturday that anybody has been turned away. We've been able to do that because of the grace of God and because of the graciousness of your giving. God so loved the world that he gave. If you love God, then you ought to be giving to a church that you know is committed to the community, committed to changing the world, and committed to helping people breathe just a little bit easier. I can speak for no other entity, but I'm telling you, New Birth has that kind of commitment. I want to challenge you even now on this, the second Sunday in December, that all of our tithers, you know what is asked and required of you according to the book of Malachi, that you'll grab your phone and you'll begin to give your seed even now. I want to ask all of our visitors, those of you who have stumbled onto our streaming service today, that you'll give even in this moment. On the next couple of weeks, we're going to be a blessing to young people whose parents are incarcerated. Going to be a blessing to those who have been flushed by social services, who find themselves wards of the state. or otherwise disadvantaged and disenchanted because of unemployment ravaging our society. I want you to partner with us. I want you to be a blessing to this community. We're mindful that the call on New Birth is not to the steeple, but it is to the street corner, that we've got to go to the uttermost parts of the earth. There are those of you who have found yourself with a waging gap between you and God and you and church, and today is your first foray back into fellowship and relationship. I so desperately would love to be your pastor to help walk you through the development of your life and the stages of maturity. I ask that you would consider becoming a part of our family. We are not a clique. We are a circle of believers who realizes that by ourselves we can't, but together we can. I've been in a series over just last week. This will be the second week of Sanctified Christmas Shopping. Sanctified Christmas Shopping. I want you to join me in Matthew chapter 2. Matthew chapter 2, verse number 11. Matthew 2, verse number 11. There's somebody who's on your heart and your spirit, somebody who called you recently, or somebody who you keep forgetting to call. I want you to invite them to come and be a part of this worship experience. It's not just going to change your life, but it is going to enhance theirs. Matthew chapter 2, verse number 11. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary. They bowed down and worshiped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. I want to preach for a little while today using as a subject, this is not that. This is not that. I still bear the scars of trauma from 10th grade. When I failed my final paper in civics class, my assignment was to do a research on President Roosevelt. I failed to listen attentively. And because I missed the fact that my focus was supposed to be on Theodore Roosevelt, I did my paper on Franklin Delano Roosevelt. Everybody in the class had a different commander-in-chief, and my negligence disrupted the order. While it is that Theodore and Franklin had the same last name, they had very little else in common. One was a Democrat and the other a Republican. Yes, both of them were born into rich families. Both of them survived assassination attempts. Theodore was successfully married, while Franklin's was just for public appearance. Theodore was very athletic, while Franklin was bound by a wheelchair. And while it is even up to this hour that Franklin is more popular, it was actually Theodore Roosevelt who said, comparison is the thief of joy. There are so many of you who are setting yourselves up to be robbed this holiday season because you don't even realize that comparison is the thief of joy. You're not happy because you're looking at somebody else's post. You find yourself in depression because you're seeing somebody else's car, envious of somebody else's gifts. Research has revealed that people compare themselves, hear this, to the fittest person when evaluating how fit they are. To be able to compare who or how you are cooking by what you are seeing on the cooking channel by professionals. Unsurprisingly, it causes one to feel inadequate, inferior, and insufficient. However, when somebody is asked to compare themselves with moderate ability, it subsides the anxiety. Social cognitive psychologists have long known that when somebody wants to feel better about themselves, they compare themselves to somebody worse off. And it immediately gives them an injection of enthusiasm because they feel like their life is better. Most people get trapped trying to find a comparison to who you are because they no longer have access to you. Think it not strange, somebody from your former life trying to return through the back door because they realize only after critical analysis that they can't find another you. And God knows they can't find a better you. You have to have the security to know that even with all of your flaws, all of your brokenness, all of your mistakes, there is no comparison. I want you to lay hands on yourself and declare out loud, there is no comparison. I want you to stop looking out the window and start looking in the mirror. You're going to be happier about who you are and your station in life. You're going to keep drowning in disappointment and depression when you keep trying to compare. I'm graced of God. I drive a Tesla. And I went to the gym the other day, and a sister who was in the gym working out the same time as I was came out just as I was leaving. She was parked right next to me. She was parked next to me in a Prius. She looked over at me and said, "We got the same kind of car." I said, no. No, this is a Tesla X. She said, "I know, I got a Prius. Both of them are electric cars." It's like somebody thinking they have something in common with you just because you both have a heartbeat. You are not the same. The difference is distinctive, not just because of the doors, but because of the experience. Have you ever wondered what happened in the frontal cortex of the mind of the second wise man? Is that when it is that they hobble their way into the manger? According to Matthew chapter 2, verse number 11, they begin to worship our born Savior. And the first wise man, watch what he does. He opens up his gift and displays he has gold. But nobody has ever interviewed what was going on in the mind of the second wise man. Because he's got to look over and see the first one has gold, but he knows all he has is frankincense. They had been traveling, but they didn't know what each other was carrying. There's so many people who you think are close to you, but they don't know what you carry. They don't know the gift that's in you. It is not until you have been unwrapped by the circumstances of life that they realize that it's gold in you. Gold, hear this, is $1,680 an ounce. And frankincense is just $3 a pound. You missed that. Gold is $1,680 an ounce, and frankincense is $3 a pound. It takes 16 ounces to make a pound, which means the first wise man's gift cost $26,880, and the next wise man, all his gift cost was $30. So many times you are looking at weight when you don't know wisp. What do you mean, Pastor? I'm telling you that both of those gifts, the gold and the frankincense, both of them, in order for them to work, require fire. I told you on last week, in order for you to prove the value of the gold, how long can it stay in the fire? I shared with you last Sunday, if it could sustain the heat, it's 24 karat gold. But that is not the evidence for frankincense. for frankincense. You know it's real, hear this, when it's been consumed by the fire. That's the problem with this generation. Is this generation wants to shine when the gospel requires you to diminish. Gold that shines bright, but frankincense disappears. There's so many of you who really have not been consumed by the Holy Ghost because there's too much of you left. When you've been burned by the Holy Ghost, you're able to say, not my will, but your will be done. I wish somebody would catch on fire. I want you to catch on fire to the point where you don't even remember how you used to think, how you used to live, what you used to desire, and who you used to want to be with. The fire consumed it. If compared prematurely, you'll look at that frankincense in that open satchel brought by the wise man, and you'll think that his gift is good for nothing. While gold is for currency, it's for fillings in dentistry, for cavities, for jewelry. It's a conduit used for TVs. What is frankincense used for? Frankincense, hear this, soothes inflammation. Arthritis, hear this, in blanket terms, is nothing more than an effect or an impact on joints. When you liquefy frankincense and put it on the exterior of the upper dermis, it begins to open up the joint so that which caused pain is finally released. May look like it don't do nothing, but frankincense will reverse inflammation in the body. Look at what it is that this wise man has brought. He's brought frankincense when his co-worker brought gold. Frankincense is used for hormone imbalance. Our bodies produce chemicals that affect functionality that are directly impacted to our mood. Place a few drops in a humidifier. When you begin to take it in, you begin to alleviate anxiety, begin to assassinate stress. You begin to redirect the course of menopause, but you got to take the frankincense in. The person next to him got gold, but all he's bringing is frankincense. Hear this, the frankincense eases respiratory problems. The anti-inflammatory properties of frankincense oil can help ease the conditions like asthma. Take a few drops of frankincense and you put it in a bowl of hot water and you inhale the fumes, and frankincense will stop an asthma attack. Frankincense, here it is, not gold, maintains oral health, prevents bad breath, tooth decay, sores in your mouth. It helps, hear this, frankincense does, when it's taken orally, it helps lower diabetes, heart disease, helps restore memory, and helps ensure fertility. The first wise man, if you're looking through the jaded eye of a retina of comparison, you think that gold is the better gift. But when you come in a little bit closer, you understand that this was a gift of homeopathic medicine. But to critical believers and thinkers, you got to ask, why are you giving homeopathic medicine, here it is, to an infant? The wise man was giving it to baby Jesus, hear this, as a preventative medicine. Because the wise man knew, hear this, that he needed to ensure that Jesus would not be a wounded healer. That in 30 years from the moment he got the gift, he was going to lay hands on the sick and recover all. But he had to make up in his mind, I got to give something to Jesus so when it's time for him to flow in his gift, he's not handicapped. So watch what the wise man did. He gave baby Jesus frankincense and put it on his hands. So he wouldn't have arthritis and find himself as a hypocrite. Kervance, when he would tell the man, stretch forth your hand. He had to use frankincense, hear me, so that there would be a moment when there were those who could not speak. What's wrong with the boy? The spirit keeps throwing him in the water. But he had to put frankincense on him so that he would be able to breathe at a place of capacity. He had to put frankincense so that Jesus would have hormonal imbalance. And that would be corrected when he's fighting through his own depression and say, Lord, let this cup pass from my mouth. Nevertheless, not my will, but your will be done. He says, I'm giving you this gift. Hear this. Because you got too much to do to be sick. I'm saying this to somebody. I don't know where you are, but I feel like I need to repeat it. I feel Holy Ghost right through here. You got too much to do to be sick. I need you to personalize that and lay hands on yourself. I got too much to do to be sick. Ain't nobody got time for COVID-19. Ain't nobody got time for kidney failure. Ain't nobody got time for your cancer flaring back up. I got too much to do. And when you're sick, you don't need gold. When you're sick, you need the power of frankincense to be able to give you holistic breakthrough. I know this is supposed to be a Christmas service, but I speak healing for every person in the bed. I speak strength to every person that's feeling dizzy and faint. I feel renewal for every person that's got a nightstand filled with medication. You don't need gold. You need frankincense. Why would he give it to him? Because he said, I got to get you prepared for what you were born to do. I ain't looking at that gold because I know the gold looks good, but it can't heal you. I know the gold is shiny, but it's not going to give you what it is that you need. Many of you who are passing by, you're not members of New Birth. You're not even members of the body of Christ. Some of you who are watching, you're not even saved. And so on this Christmas sermon, I wanted to tell you why it is you got to stop your religion shopping. I'm telling you why it is that God is better than anything you've ever had. I'm telling you, not just God, but I'm telling you that Jesus has no comparison. Jesus is He's better than Abraham, because according to John 8:58, very truly I tell you, before Abraham was, I am. Jesus is better. He's better than Moses, because Moses had to lift up his hand, but Jesus on an old rugged cross stretched out his hand so that we could walk from bondage into liberation. Jesus is better than John. Because even John had to testify, there is a greater one than me that is coming. Jesus is better than Muhammad, because Muhammad is just a prophet, but Jesus is the Savior. Jesus is better than Buddha, because Buddha was born in 563 BC, but Jesus is Alpha and Omega. Bring your children here. Jesus is better than Superman, because no kryptonite can take him down. He said, no man takes my life. I lay it down, and if I lay it down, I can pick it back up again. Jesus is better than Wonder Woman. He don't need bracelets, because he took nails in his hands and nails in his feet. Jesus is better than Aquaman, because he don't have to go underwater, but he'll walk on water and say, if you believe in the Father, believe also in me. Jesus is better than Thor, because he don't need a hammer, because he already got the cross. Jesus is better than your circle, because he's a friend that sits closer than any brother. Jesus is better than your job, because you can lose that, but lo, he is with you always, even to the end of the earth. Jesus is better than any of that. He's better than any of that. Because I told you already about Theodore Roosevelt. I told you already, hallelujah, about the Roosevelts. But I forgot to tell you, even in the course of American history, Jesus is better than that. Jesus is better than Andrew Jackson, the 7th president of the United States, who suffered emotional and physical maladies. When inaugurated in 1962, Andrew Jackson had rotting teeth, had chronic headaches, had failing eyesight, bleeding in his lungs, internal infection, and 2 bullet wounds. So Jesus is better than Andrew Jackson. Jesus is better than Grover Cleveland, the 22nd president, who suffered from obesity, gout, tumors in his mouth, and died of a heart attack at the end of his term. Jesus is better than William Taft, the 27th president, over 300 pounds, had sleep apnea, high blood pressure, and diabetes. Jesus is better than Woodrow Wilson, the 28th president, who suffered from hypertension, headaches, double vision, strokes, and couldn't even write with his right hand. And most documents were signed by his wife in private because he was embarrassed. His hand couldn't work in public. Jesus is better than George Herbert Bush, who authorized for cocaine to be offered into the black community. Jesus is better than George W. Bush, who started a war even though he knew there were no weapons of mass destruction. Jesus, y'all ain't saying nothing to me, is better than Donald Trump, because Jesus said, I am the way, I am, here it is, the truth, and I am the life. Jesus is better than Senator Perdue, because Senator Perdue profited off of our pain and took money off of COVID-19. Jesus is better than Senator Loeffler, because he did not do it for himself, but he did it for sinners like me and you. Jesus is better than anybody. I gotta tell you this, I searched all over, I couldn't find nobody. I searched high and low, and I still can't find nobody, nobody greater, nobody greater, nobody greater. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. Can't nobody do me like the Lord. He picked me up. He turned me around. He healed my body. He healed my body. He healed my body. And I'm running. I'm running. I'm running.
Hey. Hallelujah.
If anybody asks you, what's the matter with me? Tell them I'm saved. Sanctified, and I'm running.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
This is not that. When you understand who Jesus is, when you understand who you are, when you understand what you've been through, you will be delivered from the curse of comparison, looking at other people's plate. My grandmother used to say, stop counting other people's food and just thank God for what you have. I need somebody right where it is that you are, on that couch, in that bed, in your car, in this studio. Would you lift up that hand right where you are? There is no comparison. I don't care who you pull up. I don't care who you get after me. God, help me in here. I don't care who you try to replace me with. There is no comparison. I know you're trying to ignore me, but you see me. There is no comparison. I'm fly and broke. I can't hear nobody. I got it going on even while I'm falling apart. There is no comparison. I'm praying for every lifted hand that God would deliver you from the curse of comparison. That you'll see the value of who you are, of what you bring, what you possess, and the gift that is inside of you. Stop looking at other people's gold when all you got is frankincense. It smells good, but it's good for your body. It's good for your soul. I know so many times we shout, we give God glory for what we have, but I want to defy the narrative. Before Christmas ever comes, I want you to give God glory, praise, thanksgiving, honor. Hear this. I want you to shout only if you know you are a gift. Only if you know you are valuable, even whatever it is, the scars that you have. Come on, I can't hear you. Would you bless him? Because I know what I bring to the table. Hallelujah. There is no comparison. I'm telling you, you ought to stop your church search now. It ain't no church in the world like New Birth. I'm telling you, there's nowhere else where you can have this kind of experience, this kind of encounter with our God. I'm going to be your pastor. I want to tell you that I got strings attached selfishly. I want you to hear from me. I want to be your pastor. But do you know what would give me even greater delight? Is if today you make Jesus your Lord. You make up in your mind, I can't get nobody like him. Nobody else is going to love me like this. Nobody else is going to put up with my mood swings. Nobody else can handle how it is that I switch up real quick. But I'm going to give my life over to God. This has been a damnable year. But I made it because of the grace of God, because of the mercy of God, and because of the love of God. I want you to get saved today. I want you to join the church today. I want you to give your life over to God on this day. Lastly, here's what I want you to do. All three of the wise men, if there were three, they brought different gifts that had different values in the market, but had the same appreciation from the master. I want you to get a gift in your hand, in your possession, that says, I may not be able to give like somebody else, might not be able to sow like somebody else, might not be able to invest like somebody else, but it's going to help somebody. It's going to do something for somebody. It's going to help somebody pull themselves back together again. Our tithers, you know what is expected of you, that 10% of what God has given to you, you give back into the storehouse. For our visitors, our friends, our looky-loos, those who just tiptoed in, here's what I want you to do. I want you to give a gift today. Because it's been a rough year, it's been a trying year, it's been a hard year. I want you to give a gift that says, look, I ain't even looking in somebody else's plate. I'm not looking in somebody else's envelope. Not looking at somebody else's post. This is what I offer to God. So those of you that can, I want you to give a gift, a 365 on this day. 365, because every day God kept touching my body. Every day he allowed me to wake up without assistance. Every day he gave me the grace to breathe on my own. That's if you're giving at a gold level. You're giving at frankincense. I want you to give a gift of 180. I want you to give a gift of 180 because I'm believing, here it is, that things are getting ready to turn around for me. Sooner or later, it's going to work on my favor. I don't know how God's going to do it, but I trust him for it. Last but not least, I'm going to deal with it on next Sunday, the gift of myrrh. You don't want to miss this. You don't want to be outside of the conversation, out of the loop. I want you to get a gift of 35 if you can, if you will. I want you to get a gift of 35. I want you to do it now. All the prompts are on the screen. I want us to give a gift unto God. It's not equal giving. It's equal sacrifice. I got to say that to you again. It is not equal giving. It's equal sacrifice. I can't give what somebody else is giving, but I'm doing it with a pure heart, and I'm doing it with clean hands. I'm grateful because I believe in my spirit man. Today, you are being cured from the curse of comparison. Today, you are being delivered into loving yourself. The soundtrack for this week, hear me, is I searched all over. And I can't find nobody. Search high and low. and I still can't find nobody. Come on, sing it, everybody. Come on, nobody greater. Nobody. Nobody greater. Come on, would you sing it out loud, everybody? I searched all over.
I searched all over.
Couldn't find. Search high.
Still
looking out the window. Start looking in the mirror. I'm grateful you worship with us. I'm finished, but we not through. I need you to stay tuned. There's some information I want to share with you. I'm excited about your future, and I'm excited about the gift you are about to open up, and that gift is inside of you. Stay tuned.
For the visitors that don't know what's going on, let me just give you a news flash. We are new birth.
It's been 2 years since Dr. Brian delivered his first sermon here as our newly appointed pastor. Since then, he's galvanized our ministry.
Something good is getting ready to happen.
He has taken us to new levels, impacting lives spiritually and mentally. Even throughout the unprecedented health, social, and political changes of 2020, Dr. Bryant has been able to stand as a beacon of pastoral leadership. As New Birth opens its arms wide for those in need, we thank God for Dr. Bryant's vision, fortitude, and determination. Celebrating Dr. Jamal Harrison Bryant. Hey, and it's Christmas time, and we want to show our leader and shepherd, Pastor Bryant, our love and appreciation. Send your gifts and cards by Sunday, December 20th, and Merry Christmas from New Birth. And because of the holidays, don't forget there's no group therapy for the remainder of the year. Spend time with your family and pray for our members who are experiencing illness and loss. By the grace of God, each and every week, the King's Table continues to feed the community. And if you're in need, just pull up Saturday from 10 a.m. until 12 noon right here at New Birth. Just pop the trunk. We'll fill you up at the King's Table. It's time for our annual Christmas City Toy Giveaway. New Birth, the need is great. We need your support. Please donate toys or contribute online through our website, PushPay or Givelify. Wake up and worship with us Christmas Day. We invite you to join us for a virtual worship Friday, December 25th, 9:30 a.m. Don't miss this powerful message as we celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And you don't want to miss our New Year's Eve celebration Thursday, December 31st, 12:30 p.m. and 10:30 p.m. Musical guests for 10:30 p.m. service, the uplifting and powerful vocalist, Kiara Shear. Tell your family, your friends, and your neighbors to tune in. And that's going to do it for our video announcements.
Your search should be over. You can't find a better God than our God. And you can't find a greater church than this church. I want to release a blessing over your life. I extend prayers of peace. Over 275,000 people have lost their lives to COVID-19. The numbers are skyrocketing around our nation. We are now in the midst of a second wave. I'm believing that the grace and the properties of frankincense are going to hit your family, hit your life. I want you to repeat after me right where it is that you are. Walk with God, and He'll walk with me. Talk with God, and He'll talk with me. Listen to God, and He'll listen to me. Build for God, and He'll build for me. love God because he first loved me. Would you lift that hand as high as you see yourself going? What was somebody else's ceiling is going to be your floor. Now unto him who's absolutely able to do anything but fail. May God make you sleepless until you help somebody. May God make you restless until you help yourself. May God irritate you until you have enough sense to worship him. And may God bless you until you have to give stuff away. Henceforth, now and forevermore, the blessed people of God said amen. God bless you. I can't wait to see you next time. Say cheese.